This is the phony war, okay? The phony war of 1939 to 1940, the Drôle de Guerre, the Zitzkrieg, the Dziwna Wojna in Polish, the Boer War, B-O-R-E, the Twilight War. What did it mean? From September 1939 to May 1940, 7 to 8 months, there was a state of war, technically, between Britain and France on the one side and Nazi Germany on the other. It was also at war with Poland and was crushing Poland in this time. But the British and the French, by and large, simply sat there. At one point, just for window dressing, the French army advanced about 10 miles into the Saarland, but stayed there for a while and then came back, but did nothing in order to relieve pressure on Poland. At this point, the forces in the field were 110 divisions for the British and the French, 23 for the Germans. So the Germans could have been crushed in 2 weeks. World War II in the West over in 2 weeks. Hitler out, Nazism over. But that's not what they wanted. And that's the same thing we're getting now, right? The propaganda, oh, the ISIS, they're so formidable. They're so sophisticated. They're a mighty force. That's ridiculous. They're 25,000 psychotic patsies, brigands, double agents, and God knows what. You could roll over them in precisely 2 weeks. But if you go back to 39-40, you will see that under the cover of this phony war, nothing happened. Hitler finished off Poland. Hitler was then prepared. He was able to then get ready to roll over Denmark in a few hours and then to roll over Norway and then to concentrate in the West when he finally brought his army back from Poland to the West. Right? So this was a suicidal policy. This is exactly what they're doing now. You heard some of that legalist idiocy that I just said, right? Oh, you can't take down the ISIS website. At one point, there was a proposal to start some forest fires in the Black Forest to interfere with Nazi logistics. And the head of the Royal Air Force said to a guy who proposed it, "You can't do that. It's private property." I'm thinking of Colonel Bat Guano in Dr. Strangelove. So we just heard the Turkish foreign minister on TV just a few minutes ago saying, oh, sending civilians to fight in a war is a crime. We can't do that. Sounds like you can't burn the Black Forest. It's private property. The guy who had the best line on this was Senator William Borah. Remember him? B-O-R-A-H. Big critic of Woodrow Wilson, enemy of the Treaty of Versailles, League of Nations. His quote from September 1939, he figured it out quite quickly. There's something phony about this war, and the phony has emerged in the last week with the siege of Kobane. So the Kurds right now are the Poles. The Kurds are getting slammed, just like Poland was slammed. Why? Because the generals then did not want a war with Hitler. They wanted a war with Stalin. They wanted to fight the Soviet Union, not Hitler. So they wanted a different war. And they were willing to do anything. Welcome back to Sports Crisis Radio. So we're going through these many parallel similarities between the phony war of 1939-40 and the current situation vis-a-vis ISIS. In those days, the generals, the British and the French generals, were appeasers of Nazism. Many of the French generals were members of the Cagoule, which is sort of the somewhat lower level but still important directorate or dirty operations society. And then at the higher level, some of them were also members of La Synarchie, right, the Synarchs, the elitist, corporatist group that was supposedly fomenting the French empire. And that included Marshal Pétain, was, of course, part of this this entire operation, right? All kinds of things to be said about him. But these generals basically wanted war with the Soviet Union, not with Hitler. So they were willing to sacrifice the Poles, the Kurds, in order to fight, well, not the Soviet Union, but Russia. today. So with that, you can see these parallels. There was even a treaty to, there was a formal commitment to defend Poland, but they didn't do it. So therefore, they were fighting, they were pretending to fight Hitler with the Saarland invasion, and the French general staff was actually planning, let's find a way to go into Finland and fight the Soviets in Finland. Let's go into Baku in the Caspian and try to cut off the Soviet oil, and on, fantastic schemes well beyond their capabilities. They kept a large army in the Middle East, the French, presumably to get ready to attack the Soviets in some way. So all of this very, very similar. And what it shows is that there are powerful forces in the Pentagon. These are defeatists, appeasers, pro-ISIS. There's a pro-ISIS network in the Pentagon, and the general U.S. establishment is supporting a phony war. I can't tell you exactly what Obama's relationship to this is. You'll remember he tried to defend himself by saying it was the fault of the intelligence agencies. Then we had Biden come out and say it's the fault of the Saudis, the Turks, and the Emiratis. Big blowback against both of those, although not prominent for the average person. So what do we have now? We can't really tell. My guess is Obama is certainly aware that this is happening, but that the actual decisions are coming from these people that we see. Has Dempsey gone over to the Petraeus faction? Good question. And for some of these other people, you see Gates attacking Obama, Panetta now attacking Obama, Hillary attacking Obama, and all of these are more warmonger than Obama. And therefore, I tell you, in the remainder of this election campaign, the only thing you can do is pick the biggest, ugliest warmonger face and attack that. And it's McCain. It's hashtag arrest McCain for ISIS. That adequately subsumes a whole lot of other people and other forces. So there we have it. We do need an ultimatum to that new Sultan Erdogan in Ankara. And the other thing I have to point out, all of these characters on NPR, the journalistic hacks are now spinning out justifications why this has to be so, right? Why doesn't Turkey flatten some ISIS? Why don't they at least close the border, drive the ISIS out of Turkey or arrest them, round them up? They could do all that very easily. Oh, the criticism is unfair, we hear. No, if Turkey will not act, then kick them out of NATO. How? We're obligated to defend Turkey against what? Assad? This is absolutely ridiculous. Also notice, one organization that we know to be completely controlled by the CIA, and that is the Pakistani Taliban, right? They've practically got it written on their banner and their charter that they're from the CIA. The Taliban of Pakistan have now embraced ISIS. This reminds me of that moment in about, 2004, when Zarqawi of the Ansar movement in Iraq decided that he would swear eternal loyalty and fealty to Al-Qaeda and bin Laden. It happened at a moment when the Bush administration propaganda apparatus knew they needed that tremendously. Another aspect of this is breaking the set. Oh my gosh, whatever happened to Russia today? Breaking the set, Abby Martin's program, she wasn't there, but well, that's her program. She signed for it, so to speak. The show is given over to a warmonger who, despite the fact that it's RT, Russia Today, attacks Russia for supporting Assad. So the place becomes a showcase for anti-Assad warmongers. That's not so different. I don't think that's really a radical break from what she had on there before. Now, one or two other foreign policy stories. The CIA had hoped to launch a color revolution in Hong Kong. I should probably say that MI6 tried to do it, because the networks generally maintain their orientation towards the colonial power. So here we have this guy, Wong, or Wonk, depending on the pronunciation, I guess, whether it's Cantonese or Fujian or whatever. So they wanted to try a color revolution with this idiotic demand, right? Talk about a process reform. We want to have primaries instead of a list of candidates. Oh, my God. That's not exactly the great revolutionary program. But now this color revolution is more or less zerplatzt. It has deflated. And the Umbrella Men, the Umbrella Men, of course, famous from New York City in the late 1950s, the Umbrella Men have decided to go home. There's also an attempt to gin up a crisis around the DPRK, North Korea, that there's been fighting between the DPRK and the ROK, at least exchanges of firing. Putin says Kasparov should stick to chess. Yeah. Not only should he stick to chess, he should stop associating with that national Bolshevik, i.e. neo-fascist, Limonov. So we've got all of that happening. This is the phony war, okay? The phony war of 1939 to 1940, the Drôle de Guerre, the Zitzkrieg, the Dziwna Wojna in Polish, the Boer War, B-O-R-E, the Twilight War. What did it mean? From September 1939 to May 1940, 7 to 8 months, there was a state, right? The propaganda, oh, the ISIS, they're so formidable. They're so sophisticated. They're a mighty force. That's ridiculous. There are 25,000 psychotic patsies, brigands, double agents, and God knows what. You could roll over them in precisely 2 weeks. But if you go back to 39-40, you will see that under the cover of this whole, this nothing, in order to relieve pressure on Poland. At this point, the forces in the field were 110 divisions for the British and the French, 23 for the Germans. So the Germans could have been crushed in 2 weeks. World War II in the West, over in 2 weeks. Hitler out, Nazism over. But that's not what they wanted. And that's the same thing we're getting now. Phony war. Nothing happened. Hitler finished off Poland. Hitler was then prepared. He was able to then get ready to roll over Denmark in a few hours, and then to roll over Norway, and then to concentrate in the West when he finally brought his army back from Poland to the West. Right. So this was a suicidal policy. This is exactly what they're doing now. A state of war, technically, between Britain and France on the one side and Nazi Germany on the other, was also at war with Poland and was crushing Poland in this time. But the British and the French, by and large, simply sat there. At one point, just for window dressing, the French army advanced about 10 miles into the Saarland, but stayed there for a while and then came back. But did